Hey guys, today I will be showing you, in my opinion, the best way to do your product research. So how I like to do my product research, I like to combine my own checklist with the data of online research tools. So there's a lot of videos out there on YouTube on how to do your online research with tools such as Jungle Scout or Seller Prime or anything like that. That's not the difficult part. The difficult part is determining whether it actually does have a lot of potential or not. You see a lot of people asking on Facebook when they find a high potential product if it does actually have high potential, because there might be some things that the computer program missed out on. So that's where this checklist comes in handy. I'll quickly show you what happens if you change some numbers. So let's say, let's put this at 1, put this at 1, 9, 4, 4. So it's interactive, it will give a score accordingly to your input. So 1, 1, it goes down. So if there's only a score of 55, the product does not have a lot of potential. You should not go for this product. So that's basically how the sheet works, and I'll be posting it in my Facebook group again. In this example, I'll be using Seller Prime as my online research tool. It's fairly cheap and it offers a lot of great features such as keyword research. I've already chosen this product for the for this example, and it's not about how to find high potential products with research tools, it's about determining whether it does actually have high potential or not. So when you go to overview, you go to product keywords, you will get a lot of keywords that are and their search volume monthly. So that's also a great feature of Seller Prime. And for example, you get a listing quality index, which bases a score on your listing according to these bullet points. So I'll put a link in the description below, and they offer a 7-day free trial. I've already gone through the product IDs. It just basically filters out products that have really good numbers. So these are all high potential products according to Selling Prime. And I chose this one, and let's now put the numbers of this product into the sheet, and let's check if it actually does have potential or not. Alright, so there's a couple of things that are not that great for this product. So for example, there are 5 out of the top 10 competitors that have more than 100 reviews, which means with this number of reviews, it will be a bit harder to get to page 1. With a good quality listing though, it can be done. So whenever the numbers are not that great, it will give a comment, and if the numbers are good, it will give no comments. So the total score for this product is 83, which means that the product looks good and there's potential to for this product to become very successful. So the total score which you can get is 100, and the questions are fairly straightforward. So for example, if it is a year-round seller, just put in yes, put in a 1 if yes, put in a no, put in a 0 if no. So for example, if I put in a 0, keep in mind that seasonal products might have a big demand fluctuation, so it will give you comments if the score aren't optimal. You can, if you want, change the weights of the criteria. As long as all the weights add up to 100, it should be fine. But these are the numbers that I would recommend. So if you change this, for example, to 3, it does not add up to 100, and it will show you, oops, the weights do not add up to 100. Make sure it does to get accurate data. So let's change this back to 5. And whenever the score is higher than 85, it will say the following. So if we change it to 91, it will tell you that it's a great product and it definitely looks promising. So always make sure to aim for at least 85 before you actually go for a product. That's about it. Thanks for watching, and I'm out.